very nice to get a welcome, warm welcome message from many people like Professor Yang and Professor Remo and Paula. He always emailed me about the hotel arrangement, all these details, and I'm really appreciative of that. So my talk today is about cloud computing, in particular, scientific computing on clouds. Now, is the sound loud enough? It's okay, right? So here, my main concern about cloud is what? It's a very popular platform in data processing. However, to be popular, you have to handle many other issues, including scientific computing and the data mining, all these issues. So today's talk, I'm going to propose a few challenges. What's the problem here? And these are new problems. You know, when you involve many new domains, you meet this kind of problem, and we try to propose some solution, possible solutions. Yeah, this is what. Okay, so today I'm going to talk about possible challenges and possible solutions. In particular, I'm going to give you our contribution, mainly these three translators. And these three translators are very interesting. In the past, whenever you have a program, you're running on PC, it's very slow, right? Many people have the misconception, hey, I transported this program onto cloud, it will be faster. In reality, it's not true. Maybe slower, because the overhead, because middleware, because the layer of difficulties and overheads. So today I'm going to talk about this. In the future, is there any possibility whenever you write a sequential code, let's say C or Java, I'm going to transport this code out to cloud. Not only efficient, also speed up is very good, right? So this is my contribution we are talking about today. Three areas. First, the famous MATLAB, how to translate into MapReduce. Second, the sequential Java, how to translate to MapReduce. And right now we are still doing Java code, how to translate to Spark, the new cloud programming model. I'm going to, because time constraint, I'm going to skip many things, but today I'm going to briefly discuss these are historical perspective of these cloud computing, right? Initially we have supercomputing, then bankrupted many companies, then class computing cheaper, then grid computing popular, and hopefully in using a socialist system we can solve the computing resource issue, right? However, it's not working because many people, most people are in some way selfish, right? People are not willing to share resources with you, right? So now it's cloud computing. At least the economic model is reasonable. You pay whatever you use. So what's in cloud computing? In my opinion, cloud computing is really, after grid computing, these are three major issues, right? Virtualization, pay-per-use service, and available, scalable, reliable, anytime, anywhere. Now the question is, today we really discuss is scalable. Now, this is a technical committee on scalable computing, right? Scalable means what? Means whenever you use more CPUs, your time is reduced further, right? That's the idea, right? However, if your code just transfer to cloud, it's not working. It's not really scalable. You have to parallelize this code on cloud. How to parallelize? That's the issue, right? Now, people propose many ideas. This is grid computing and cloud computing. That's a different perspective. Cloud computing is economical model, is pay-per-use model, so very suitable for capitalist country, basically pay whatever you use. Now, in ideal case, of course, cloud computing has many features, right? Including, I don't want to discuss more, but today, topic is scalable. Scalable, unlimited resource. Now, in many cases, that's true. Unlimited resource, for example, Amazon provides many million CPU, right? So if you rent 10,000 CPU or 1,000 CPU, it's unlimited, right, to you. The question is, in reality is what? Many issues still there, including particularly security, trust, and also many issues, right? And scalable is another issue. Now, automatic parallelization is still a major issue. In other words, whenever you have sequential code, you want to put this code on cloud, you have to rewrite the code in cloud programming language. In particular, today, mainly people are talking about many models, and the popular model probably is MapReduce or Spark. Now, scalable, we can say this one service as a software service, like Google, right? This guy implemented by vendors, so that's why it's already scalable. Why? Because people implement it for you. When you search my name, EPEN, on Google, how many CPU are working on EPEN? Maybe 1,000, maybe 3,000, right? You don't know. It's scalable already. The tricky question is, if it's infrastructure as a service, then I just give you a bare bone. You have to implement everything yourself, meaning you have to implement in cloud format. That's the issue. Now, of course, the platform as a service, vendors implement something, you implement something, so eventually it's a cloud system. So, in cloud computing, mainly talk about two things, right? How to store and how to compute, right? If you solve these two problems, of course, everything should be effective, efficient, and scalable. The question is how to store. Now, of course, many storage mechanisms, for example, Hadoop system, Google file system, and so on, right? And in computing, also many, right? Popular one, for example, batch processing, stream processing, MapReduce is one functional programming, and Spark recently on Twister is by iterative MapReduce. And Azure is basically Microsoft stuff, and Drive is another one, and right now many models are adopted by Amazon already. So wherever you rent some cloud system, you know, you rent 300 CPU, login, these programming models already available, so you can program based on these models. The question is, these models are still difficult to program, especially in many domains, many applications, right? So here, the question characteristics of ideal cloud computing is anywhere, anytime, scalable. Now, scalable is a major concern, right? Scalable means what? Means anytime you use more CPU, your time is reduced accordingly, proportionally, and the best chance is what? It's a linear speed up. Right? If you are computing 1 hour with one CPU, two CPU, half hour, four CPU, one quarter, right? So, but many times it's not really true. So here, how to do this, right? And many scientific computing, for example, require a lot of data transfer, a lot of communication patterns, and so on. And it's not easy to solve this problem on cloud computing. So how do we solve this problem? Okay, in reality, cloud is suitable for. Now, many people say cloud is already successful. In certain way, it is true. How? Because cloud is really like a Google search engine. For search, in parallel computing domain, everybody knows, right? Parallel computing means what? Means you can, many people working on the same problem. The communication has to be limited. If you have too much communication, the trouble is there. Now, why? Cloud computing is already successful in the past because many applications, domains, are mainly in computing area we call the data parallel area. Data parallel application means what? Means these are not too much communication. You can partition the data into many parts and you can work on them independently. For example, database application, search, selection, compression, so on. For example, web searching, also data parallel, because you search a name, you can work on different CPUs, right? And then report the results. It's easy. Now, other issues, for example, like a web service, also data parallel, because if I have 100 CPU server, right? If you have 1 million hits, I just distribute 1 million among 100 CPUs, that's it, right? If you have 100 CPU and 100 hits, then each CPU just serves one hit. Perfect, right? So these cases are easy to handle. My question is, in the future, in cloud, if we want to implement matrix multiplication, or K-mean, all these complicated scientific computing, maybe cloud is not ready yet. That's the issue. So how to solve this issue, eventually we have to implement on this. Now, these are parallel computing models. In the past, we already used, right? Mass message passing interface, threads with Unix system, and OpenMP, high performance Fortran, and Globus toolkit is for grid computing. Now, MapReduce, iMapReduce, Spark. My concern is what? In the future, all these systems may be gone. So if you log into the Azure, the Microsoft system, right? Only cloud computing models there. MPI, no way. You cannot run. So here in the future, now let me summarize this, right? MPI, for example, is an assembly in parallel computing code. You have to arrange everything yourself. It's tough to debug, tough to program. Now, let's see OpenMP. It's much easier. For example, this code, right? This Fortran code, you just put a sentence saying, parallelize this loop, K, job done. Right? So this is a very simple solution, right? Now, of course, there are many conditions. The condition is your code has to be data independent. Between loops, you don't have data dependency. High performance Fortran is the same thing. Now, all these codes are my own code, right? So you distribute the data like this, use a command, like high performance Fortran. This is what we call the directory. And then you can just say independent, this loop, say K loop, the loop K, I want to parallelize this loop, job done. Again, condition is what? This within the loop, everything has to be parallelizable, meaning data dependent, independent. Now, here, Globus basically is what? Globus basically you have lots of between system, between organization. So you need two things. First, certification, and second is authorization. Right? Certification, authorization, meaning I allow you to use my system. Second, I have to identify who you really are. Are you really EPAM? Right. So this thing, issue solved, basically this is classical computing. Right. So now, let's see the map release. Map release is very simple, right? You have a lot of map, and you have a lot of release code. And this is the model is basically a function programming model. If you can express your application in this kind of domain, map and reduce, job done. For example, parallel computing, let's see, take an example. This one is counting how many particular words in this file. So this will parallel, in parallel counting, all these, you know, Smith, you know, George, all these names, you know, will generate. In the file, I will account, say, hey, George, you have 300 appearance. Smith, you have 350 appearance, and so on, right? Everything parallel. So here you can see the model, right? You have to understand the MapReduce clearly, then you can do the programming. Otherwise, impossible, right? So, how MapReduce work? Basically, MapReduce map, for example, this is so many words, right? You partition the file into several maps, several CPUs, and each one counting. So here, in this case, the is only one, where is one, today is one, and here everybody is one, and then you combine them together, still one, 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 and then here you have go to have two. Why two? Because in this case, go to appear one, go to appear one is two. Then you just combine vary and then reduce, and go to become four, five. Why go to become five? Because here two, here two, here one, here another one, total five addition is five, right? So whenever you express this way, your code is in parallel, efficient, it's very good and nice. However, you can see this kind of application is mainly parallel computing, data parallel application. Otherwise, you cannot do it. Now, limitation, of course, many limitations, of course. The first one, my concern is expressibility, right? So many cannot be expressed. Because time can consume, I will emphasize only a few points, right? You cannot express this model, any application. Now, if you cannot express, mean what? No matter how intelligent you are, right? You cannot implement your application code on MapReduce. In other words, you cannot run on cloud. Of course, you can still run, meaning what? Only one CPU uses this, right? You cannot implement, you cannot run on cloud efficiently, then the cloud is useless to you, right? How to solve the issue, problem? So, Spark. Now, Spark, I want to, you know, maybe this talk is also tutorial in nature, right? People ask me, what's the difference between MapReduce, Spark, based in-memory computing, different from MapReduce, this in-memory. Meaning what? Everything in memory, not in disk, is so fast. Second thing is what? It's more flexible than MapReduce. More flexible meaning what? Before it's only MapReduce, now it's more like this. You see, here you have many modules, and modules can combine together and in any way you want. Right? This is a very nice feature. So for example, in this case, you can group them together, you can hear the map filter join all these. Before it's only MapReduce, right? You have now have different models. Map filter join, group by, all these combinations, put together, including group unique, field, MapReduce. So now, more flexibility, remember, of course, give you more power. Give you more power means what? Expressibility is better. Means what? You can code your application domain much more. However, because more flexibility, more complexity, you can understand what? Coding is more difficult. You have to decide how to do it, right? So this is a tough issue. And this is, for example, MapReduce here is a Spark example, flexible. This is for counting word counting here, this is the code. So you can see the code is very abstract, right? If you don't understand this model, you even cannot do the code yourself. Now, what's my job? My job is very fancy. I say, hey, in the future, people, you don't need to understand the cloud. I translate it for you. That's very nice, right? So in the future, if you don't understand the cloud, you write a Java code and say, hey, Dr. Pan, this is my code for matrix multiplication. Can you translate on cloud? I say, yes, I translate for you. Boom. It's efficient, scalable, everything done. That's nice, right? Now, of course, if I implement everything myself, then I will open a big company making lots of billion dollars, of course, right? But it's my research. Now, my research means what? Mean my first step, all these issues already solved. Now, I just need to hire 100 software engineers. My major issue is what? I need at least $3 million, right? US dollars to invest in company. Then I can be popular guy. But of course, right now, I'm only doing research. So initial phase, remember. Now, let me show you my result, right? So all these issues, for example, Microsoft Microsoft Drive, you can do this coding, right? This coding model involve graph, you know, direct graph, write it down, and then queue all these, you program yourself. Yeah, it's like assembly in parallel computing domain, in cloud. It's very tedious, not too good, right? And writing a parallel computing cloud is basically is embarrassing in parallel computing. You can do it, and in the future, MPI, all these code system, will not be available in cloud. So in the future, how do we do it? Now let's see, what's next? Next is what? Many systems not available in the future now, right? The only way you can do it is what? Implement current MapReduce or Spark or whatever. Now, many people may ask me this question, right? So, hey, MapReduce is, popular by Google. Why don't you design your own system? What's meaning cloud? People remember, cloud means scalable, reliable, trustable. These issues are not easy. Google may spend a few thousand people working on 10 years generating this MapReduce, right? So, all these photo tolerance, all these issues already solved. If you want to, group, generate this kind of software model, it's almost impossible. So, my job is what? Using existing cloud framework, can we, on top, do something, right? So this is our work. So here, expressibility is the issue, limitation. So my proposal, this is my proposal, right? My proposal is four issues. Can you improve this model? Improve means what? Change a little bit. If you change too much, manpower is costing too much. So impossible job. Automatic translation between languages. Now this is the major issue we are focusing. Basically, if you have a Java code, can we translate into cloud code? For you, you don't have to understand cloud anymore. Right? Now, of course, the next one, the new model, like all the synchronous processing model, blah, blah, blah. All these models you can generate saying, hey, this is my new cloud computing model. Yes, but it takes a lot of time. Right? So it's not easy. And then the last one, redesign algorithm. Meaning what? Meaning when you consider cloud computing in the future, even your algorithm alone, you cannot think sequentially. You have to think in cloud format, in cloud environment. That's my thinking. Right? I can give you an example in the future. For example, simulation. Solving the partial differential equation. In the past, you always change simulation, right? You change exchange ideas, messages each step. In the future, can you change message every million steps? You do your computing alone, then change the message a little bit, then do your computing alone. Now the result may be different, right? It's true, because the computing is different. However, after millions and millions, millions iteration, the converge result may be converged. Cloud still plays a role, still successful, right? So you have to think about design algorithms differently. Now, what we have done, I just improvement. So in the past, the high-level language, of course, tedious to code, time-consuming, learning curve is big, and only experts can do it. For example, database already do this. In the past, right, if you write a SQL code, S-E-Q, SQL code in database, of course, database is a query, right, working. However, on cloud, it's not working. Why? The SQL is sequential code, right? So people design this guy called the scope, pig, hive. What's meaning? Whenever you have a SQL code database, using my system, right? This is not mine, of course, using the system, right? They translate into cloud database system. Now it's really cloud-based. Now it's effective, scalable, efficient, quick. Now, I'm trying to do the same thing. Automatic translation between sequential code and cloud. So what I'm doing is, these are just different possible improvement, right? I can skip. So for example, I MapReduce, just to try to generalize the MapReduce code. Basically, you have code, I want to do this loop, then iteration, right? Iteration meaning what? Meaning make this code more effective, more efficient. For example, if you want to try solve the two-dimensional array issue, I do the iterative this way, iterative this way, everything in the memory, then this code is more effective. Now, what's my results? My results is our research. Our research focuses on translator between traditional language and cloud language. Now, when I say cloud language, mean what? Means available cloud programming model, right? You have to program. In right now, basically, Drive, MapReduce, Spark, all these popular models. If you don't understand right now, you even cannot do cloud computing. So I created this word called Cloudify. Cloudify means what? Everything you do Cloudify, meaning your code is really scalable on cloud computing now. So this is called Cloudify. So let me give you one example. First example, translate MATLAB to MapReduce. We call it end-to-end, right? In the future, we are going to do X2M MapReduce, meaning Java to MapReduce, any language, C2 Java to MapReduce. So in the future, if successful, your code, you don't have to understand cloud computing. I translate for you, and you run on cloud system. That's very nice. Now, I have to show you something, right? When I say it's not completely successful, but I have to show you successful. The light is here, it's already there, right? Now here, we did it this way. M2M means what? You have a library, you have a MATLAB. MATLAB is a code, is a scientific computing language, right? And then we translate to MapReduce code, and I can show you. Here, this M2M, this MATLAB code is very short, right? Only two sentences, right? Calculate the minimum of this big array, loading. This two sentences translate into cloud computing, how many sentences? Two lines in MATLAB, and actually this is a cloud code, and this is 150 lines. Okay. In other words, I'm going to give you just one example. If you are effective cloud programmer, you're doing well, you are good. Two lines, you have to code into 150 lines, right? Imagine I have a Java code, 30 pages, 15,000 lines. Even your effective program probably will cost you 1 year to code, let alone maybe error, right? right? Maybe error, maybe some problem, right? But if translation by automatic translation, then it's really effective. Now, this is already not finished, right? So this is a flowchart of this code basically analyzing. It's like compiler, basically, right? We did this. And now, whenever we do translation, we have to prove two things, of course. Firstly, after translation, the cloud program is still correct, meaning what? The result is right, right? First thing. Second thing is what? After translation, the cloud program is scalable. Meaning what? Meaning more CPU use, time reduce. Otherwise useless, right? So here I can show you the two results. And in our case, you have 6 lines and 348 MapReduce code. And I can show you this is the code, and I can show you the results. Now, any code, you have some time dependency. For example, in this code, you want to try to calculate the mean. Calculate the standard deviation. Standard deviation, of course, depends on the mean, right? You have to do the mean first, then do the deviation. Now, if our program captures this feature, we can do more effective. So here, and I have this code, basically, I loaded the data and then calculated this. For example, did a lot of data dependency, right? Okay. Now, the data dependency, we use a program to capture the dependency and put in the input file. Everything is automatic. So now, this is the platform, the testing environment. Okay, like simple scheduling, and this is running data. Now, I can show you here, right? If you use the green is hand code, use writing, use a program, you know, writing has to take you 3 days to finish the code, that's okay. And this is red one, automatic code. Automatic code, red, the green code, you can see the difference is what? Minimal. Almost same, right? Meaning our result is okay. Now this is already execution time is what? Already paracomputing, okay? Already cloud paracomputing. Meaning our code is okay. Second, in this case, our red code is even better. The green code is what? By hand. The red code is by machine. Now why machine is better? Machine, we recognize all these tasks dependencies. Whenever you have dependency, we do sequentially. However, whenever we don't have any dependency between two tasks, we do parallel together. By vision, by human being, you cannot detect this parallelism. That's why the green code is worse and the red code is better. Okay. So now let me capture several other issues and then this is continued. Now, in the future, of course, we need to add the loops and so on. I will discuss this later, right? Because time issue concern, I will skip many issues. And we also did a Hadoop to twist the translation. Now, twist means what? Twist is iterative map reduce. Now, in the past, whenever people design a new system, right? Microsoft is very stubborn and arrogant in some way. Is that true? So Google designed map reduce. Microsoft will always say no. We don't have MapReduce, right? But this iterative MapReduce is called Twister, is working more effectively. And the major issue is what? This guy is designed by Indiana University, a university producer. So in this case, Microsoft already accepted this. So in the future, whenever you log into a Azure system, this programming model is already available. Okay. And we did some translation also, and I don't want to get into this detail. Translation half, okay. And the result you can see here is what? You can see the result, translation. The Hadoop is the red one, this blue is the twister. Twister is more effective, as I said before, because in memory. And then the green one is twist hand code. So in other words, we are in the middle. If you use a program to do the hand coding, you're the best. But we do machine translation, we are still better than the original. Working, but of course you can say hand coding is always the best usually because you know everything, right? Depend on program. Now, of course I want to see this. Why is it better? Because we put some merge into the system. Because wherever a programmer, my student, right? He's a very effective programmer and he knows how to design the system. Of course, we put some tricks there. Of course, the result is better. Okay, now let's see the final result. Java to MapReduce now. Java to MapReduce, whenever you program a Java code, we translate into MapReduce, and it's still effective. Now, detail I have to skip. We don't have too much time. How much time I have? Maybe 10 minutes, 5 minutes? Okay. So, here, I can skip a lot of details. Basically, you can imagine it's what? Basically, it's a compiler. Translate Java code into MapReduce code. This is compiler code. And a lot of scan, parses, instruction generation code, and so on, right? The tough issue is how to detect the data dependency and how to do the parsing, translation, all these are issues. And of course, these are engineering problems, so tough issues that us to handle, you can just see the results, right? What's the result? The result is this, okay? Let me show you the result, okay? Test on PG calculation. This is the Java code, big loop, of course. Lot of data process inside the loop, right? And we generate this code, it's called MapReduce code, and this code is generated by machine. Right. And we can see here, the major computing is what? Here, this is what? Hadoop, and this is local loop. Hadoop means what? You parallelize this, you times with this. This is what? You don't parallelize, of course, more data means what? More time, right? And finally, we can see this. This one is interesting, right? Whenever you have this linear speed up, the one means what? Sequential code Java. If you don't parallelize the code, your sequential Java is like this. Now, this blue one is what? Speed up is less than one. Less than one means what? Means slower. What's meaning? Why slower? Because overhead. So, in the future, less than one, right? Whenever you port your Java onto cloud, your code is always slower than original Java code. Why? Because cloud has a lot of overhead. Too much slowdown. Now, whenever we increase the data, into 1 million, 1 billion is still too slow. 2 to 10 billion is green. 20 billion starting getting better, right? 2 CPU getting better and speed up. And then you can see 100 billion data points. Then eventually this is 5 speed up to 5, and we reach like 3 speed up 3. Lesson, meaning what? Cloud computing. Whenever you're handling small data, don't even bother with cloud computing. Useless. Use your PC. That's it. Cloud computing and my cloudify, all the software working effectively, scalable, everything working, only the data is what? Bigger data. It's really, truly, truly billion data. Then it's useful. Otherwise, you don't. Now, our code is working, right? Translate Java code into MapReduce code. It's already working. Meaning what? Meaning the system is really effective and we show people. Result is correct, scalable. So here's the test results, performance, right? And so we reach the best speed up is 4.45. Okay. Feature one. Of course, if you say we already finished, if I claim today, right? If you give me any Java code, I can translate it into cloud code. Job done, you don't have to understand the cloud. I do it for you, running effectively. Then I'm cheating because I'm billionaire already, right? Because I translate to you, right? I can just create a server saying your input is your Java code, your output is what? Your MapReduce cloud code, and then I charge you credit card, charge you $100 to translate for you. Many people will happily do it, right? $100 translation is much lower than your labor cost. Is that true? Your labor cost maybe cost a programmer maybe 1 month. The salary is very big, right? That's not true. Not true. Reason is we translate only certain toy code. Meaning what? Big loop. No data dependency. But this feature is what? Feature is still bright. Remember, in big data, right? What's mean big data? Mainly multiple dimension. The loop is big. Well, why big loop? Why? Because the data is big. Billion means what? The loop is billion, right? Whenever you have big loop, then we can do parallel activity, right? So finally, I want to do this automatic translation, and in the future, we already do this. This is the next phase. In the future, I'm saying is what? I do translation for simple loop, but I cannot do general. But I can in the future do some specific domain, for example, partial differential equation solver. I do cloudify software for you. In the future, you don't have to understand the cloud. You can do it in this case. So domain specific is possible. Okay. And simple API now, this is one of our teachers doing this. In the past, if you have an MPI code, you cannot run on cloud. Now in the future, we translate the MPI into MapReduce or into Spark. In the future, you can still run. And the last, but not least, we are doing, I have not reported yet, the code is working, almost working. Translate C code, Java code into Spark code. Spark is a popular one, right, in the future. And then it's hopefully successful. So all three papers major in the future. 20 years later, you can see. Many people say, oh, we do translation, but I'm the original. Now, as a researcher, I always do original, then move on to different topic. But people will cite my paper. For example, my paper called Parallel Programming on Cloud. This paper, I'm going to download always the top. Cited by, so far, only 2 years, by over 30 papers in journal already. Right? So this is a successful project, I hope, in the near future. Yeah. And because of time constraint, I will stop here. Thank you very much. So you're talking about MapReduce always for the one-to-one, this kind of application, right? Certain application, is that your question?
Does this work? Oh, it does work, excellent, yeah. So I'm just asking if these scientific applications and the translations of them produce traffic patterns that if we should be testing things other than just all nodes trying to communicate with all nodes or random traffic patterns.
Answer your question, right now we don't have the capability to design your own cloud system. Now, in the past, MapReduce, Spark, all designed by Google, and Google's major job is what? Basic search engine, right? So it's a data parallel, so it's simple for them. And now in the future, if we want to design scientific computing, we have to design from scratch, like you said, communication pattern, design yourself. Then this involves a lot of changes in the MapReduce code bottom. Now, if you have time, you can do it, but this will take you in a bigger group. For example, in my group, I only supervise right now 5 students. In USA, you know, limitation is very normally small group, right? So we don't have the manpower, so my job is only one. Depend on the existing cloud and then design the connection, basically, application to this. But in the future, realistically, if you think about, let's say you are a big company, similar to Google. Google doing MapReduce for searching for data application. Now you are a bigger company like Microsoft. You really want to say cloud, can we do cloud only for data processing? Not enough, because it's small domain, right? Of course, data processing is bigger domain, but still limited domain. You want to do scientific computing, you have to design your own engine for suitable application, and this costs a lot.
Hello. My name is Lin Trung from Tuvian, Austria. I want to ask you about the perspective because at least I have two main observations. The first thing is when we are talking with the guy in the other field, like for example, simulation physics, material science, for example, yeah, over the last 30 years or even more, if we look into their program, they always write, for example, MPI, Fortran, and so on and so forth. And this continued to be like that. This is one observation.
Mexico.
Second observation is Google said, and the other guy said, MapReduce is over. So they developed like data flow and something like this. So in your talk, you advocate the way to translate from something like MPI OpenMP something like this into MapReduce and Spark and something. So I have a little bit difficult to understand, you know, what would be the future direction where we want to go, because on the one hand, I see no future if we just continue to look at the scientific code like MPI, OpenMP, Fortran. On the other hand, the guy at Google say MapReduce is over. And when we talk about programming in the cloud, we always just talking about, okay, optimize the loop transfer, you know, from this model to the other model. And then people in the cloud say, look, but the main thing in the cloud is virtualization, pay-per-view, and so on. And we have no new programming construct that actually adds into the programming model and so on. So where we are going?
I can ask the question briefly. In business domain, right, a company wants to make money, Google search is making money, right? Whenever you have a scientific computing, like let's say you say material science simulation, if your simulation result generate billion dollars, I'm quite sure Google will support your system, right? Right now, this is not the case. So in the near future, that's only my suspect, right? In the near future, Google, all these cloud companies will not support MPI, Fortran, this kind of code. Not because your code is not good, your code is good, but commercially not making money. So this is very similar to the idea. I always talk to my students about this. Ada 20 years ago is very good language. Everybody using Ada, I understand. Ada is very good. Anytime you compile an Ada code, right? Try to find an error, it will give you the error hint. Oh, integer not matching real, blah, 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 right? And once you correct all these compiler error, job done. Now here, why Ada died? Because Ada, military people don't allow you to use Ada, and people say, hey, this is costly. And then now, on the other hand, C is what? Popular. Why? C is free. Everybody use C. Now C is everybody use C. Then C is popular, then Ada done. So this mechanism is really based on popularity. In the near future, MapReduce will die also. Spark will pick up. And your simulation language using MPI, Fortran, all these will die unless computer scientists like us support it. Otherwise, yes. You are in a very difficult dilemma here. But how to solve the problem? I feel by all biology people, material science people, you need to collaborate with computer science people. We create a software bridge this one. If you depend on Google or Microsoft, your code will be dead. That's my prediction. Of course, not a reality, but that's the future. Thank you.